I rarely talk about UK politics on this channel, despite obviously living in the UK. But today I actually did want to talk about UK politics because we've had the worst mass shooting in, I think, 11 years. And it is fitting into this trend of incel, I guess, terrorists and incel shooters that has been, like, sweeping Western countries. And of course, like, Elliot Rodgers in America was one of the more prominent examples of that back in 2014 and held up as some sort of like hero in incel culture. And we're gonna actually look at the guy who did it. We're actually gonna look at his Reddit page, which shows you a lot about this guy, him posting in like the Virgin subreddit, men's rights subreddits. Subreddits also dedicated to trying to help people to stop being incels. And then we're just gonna talk about the broader culture of incel violence that we've been seeing in the last 7 or so years. Now this stuff, like I was saying, is very fresh. It actually happened yesterday, so I think we should start by covering the news angle of this. So BBC reporting a couple hours ago, it says, Jack Davison, who killed 5 people, including a young girl, and it's also been revealed one person who he killed was his own mother as well, in Plymouth, was a licensed firearm holder, police have revealed. The 22-year-old shot 2 women, 2 men, and the 3-year-old girl in a deadly 6-minute spree in a Caham area of the city on Thursday evening. Police said the incident, the worst mass shooting in Britain since 2010, is not terror-related. So that's an interesting thing to keep in mind, that the police think this has nothing to do with terrorism, like a political ideology. In online videos, Davison spoke of being beaten down and defeated by life. Devon and Cornwall Police Chief Constable Sean Sawyer said Davison was a firearms license holder. He said the weapon used in the shooting had been described as a pump-action shotgun, but police couldn't confirm, saying, we believe we have an incident that is domestically related, that has spilled into the street and seen several people lose their lives in tragic circumstances. So Davison murdered a 51-year-old woman who was known to him, and this is believed to be his mother. He then went onto the street and he shot and killed a young girl and killed the male relative of that girl. Then he shot another woman and another man. Then he went into a park where he shot another 59-year-old man who died at the scene, and then moved to Henderson Place where he shot a woman, 66, who also later died. In online videos, because this guy had a YouTube channel, Davison said he was socially isolated, struggled to meet women, and made references to incels, signing off on an 11-minute video, which appears to be his last. He said, I know it's a movie, but I like to think sometimes I'm the Terminator or something. Despite reaching almost total system failure, he keeps trying to accomplish his mission. Now, I just want to play part of this video for you. I'm not going to probably play the footage, but I'll just play for audio so you can hear him sort of talk about this stuff.
That drive that I once had, that's gone now. You know, I try, and I always keep trying. But it's like, I'm at the point now where it's like, why do I even bother? Like, for what? You know? I'm still in the same house, same situation, same position. Still, everything's still the same. For the most part, it's just been me against the world. It's just been me fighting an uphill battle with a big rock on my back, you know, while I'm seeing that don't deserve half of anything. Now, they're getting a free ride to the top. The whole premise of the Terminator movies is that, you know, everything's rigged against you. There's no hope for humanity, you know. We're on the brink of extinction, you know. These machines are unstoppable killing machines that can't be beaten, can't be outsmarted. But yet, humanity still tries to fight to the end. And I know it's a movie, but, you know, I like to think sometimes, you know, I'm a Terminator or something. And despite, you know, reaching almost total system failure, he keeps trying to accomplish his mission, you know?
So obviously an extremely tragic shooting, and the UK, of course, has very, very strong gun laws. To get access to one, you have to pass so many background checks. To have one in your house, I think you even have to show, like, the authorities that you have, like, a safe type thing to store it in. I know, like, one person who owns a firearm in the UK. So this sort of thing is, of course, extremely rare in this country. I only remember like two in my lifetime. It's probably been a couple more. So hearing this news the other day, it's not like America. It was pretty crazy. Now, typing in incels on Reddit and sorting by new about like 5 hours ago or so before a lot of the mainstream news outlets kind of picked up on this, I found his Reddit account. And you can tell it's his Reddit account because he posts links to his YouTube channel. So he posts on the Duma subreddit, missing out on teenage love and experiences and people who say it's not. And there's a picture of his thumbnail, 23-year-old virgin autist. There's another one. He also posted a picture on Rate Me. So what I want to do now is go through a lot of these posts to kind of just show you this guy's ideology. And I don't know if I'm alone in feeling this, but it feels really like kind of eerie now, like reading through a Reddit profile of someone who's detailed a lot of the reasons for why he's kind of done this shooting, and seeing the psychology behind this stuff is obviously like illuminating, but also quite disturbing. So I wanted to start with this one, this post on Rate Me. So he posted a photo of himself and he said, 22-year-old male, whether I rate, and he posted like images and videos of himself, and he said, this video I recorded a month or two ago, just seeing what I look like, apologize for this weird tone of it and me posing in it as it was just a random video. Still a male virgin 22-year-old, never had a GF, kissed a girl, etc. Why can't I get a single match on Tinder? Sure, I'm somewhat fat, but I'm built 6 foot tall. Judge for yourself and rate where you would say I'm at. Sometimes in photos, I feel I look disgusting though, and I believe they knock me down so much and make me much less attractive. I know I should try and meet more people in person, but I haven't spoken to a girl since I was 17, and now it feels impossible to meet girls. So you can already see there him kind of blaming girls for his own problems. Obviously, you can see super insecure about his own looks. Not that I would say he's like the most ugly guy, and I think it plays into a lot of the things about these incels is it's all in their own head. And even people saying, you know, you're handsome, maybe cut the body fat. Someone else saying, I'm 17-year-old gay and my heart skipped the beat when I saw your photos. You're a solid 9.5 out of 10. Someone else saying, hey, since your amazing pics include yourself shirtless, you may want to label the post not safe for work. Not complaining though. Now, dude, you're really attractive. Your facial hair suits you. Only thing I would say is maybe style your hair and smile. And then in response to this, he says, I haven't spoken to a girl since I was 17, unless one or two word responses to cashiers counts as speaking to a girl. Need to get out more, but it's been so long. Now the mental barriers have been built up so strongly, it feels like even speaking to a woman is damn near impossible. I need to break that mental barrier, but lockdown in UK is really not helping. I work in a male-dominated environment and stick to myself after leaving school, so don't have any friends, haven't had friends since school. Really, hopefully, with lockdown in UK coming to an end and maybe places I can meet up with people will start to be easier now. So in another comment on this post, he says, when I did interact with girls, it did seem they liked me, or at a bare minimum were open and friendly towards me. I've had opportunities, but I could never get over asking a girl out. Stupid, really, now I'm older, not going to let such BS stop me. But now I can't seem to meet anyone there, and online dating, I get absolutely nowhere at all. So I think even that post kind of like shows the problems with incels in general. Here you have a couple people telling him he is at least average looking, some people saying he's good looking, and all the responses are just about how he can't get women, basically. And it shows you his mindset. But, you know, loads of other posts that we're going to get into show us even more and like who he blames for all this, who he blames for his own failings. So, incels in action, he posted in, guys who lost their virginity in the late in life, 20 plus, does it still bother you? Saying, do you look back with regret? Does it affect you mentally, emotionally, perhaps even physically to this day? Or are you over that now? Are you genuinely happy and content with life, despite never having sex in your teen years? Or did the mental scars carry with you for the rest of your life? But then he was posting on a subreddit called Incel Exit, which was trying to like help people get out of this mindset that he clearly have. So then you have more stuff. So here is, should being ugly be considered a disability? And it says, I believe it is, especially for males below a certain income level. Obviously, if you're a 3 out of 10 and earn 100k a year, it doesn't apply. But below a certain looks threshold, I believe they should get a payment every month for being short or not good looking. Opinions and views on this. Do you believe being ugly is a disability? I believe it is for an 8 or a 9 out of 10. Life just flows and occurs so easily and naturally for below average males. You've got to grind, pry, and struggle. So again, like his whole sense of inadequacy comes through on these posts, and most of these posts are, you know, pretty similar. So there's another one in Virgin that says, does love hit as hard emotionally as an adult compared to a teen? Another one in Incel Exit saying, being a late bloomer in life. Another one saying, can an experienced woman really be content with an average guy? Saying, as a male virgin at 22, this worries me. A girl my age will likely be far more experienced than me. So it's just very, very clear this guy had so many problems with sexual inadequacy, seemed to think like 22 was extremely old, far too old to be like losing your virginity or getting women or anything like that. But then he talks about more like government programs to help with incels. So on Incel Exit, he writes, there should be a government-funded incel social program or rehab center. And he says, I'm generally against social programs as I'm quite libertarian, but I do believe there's a place for them. I know it's properly unlikely because society doesn't care much or believe this is a big problem. However, inceldom and male sexlessness and generally males becoming disenfranchised is rising. I would say this kind of thing doesn't have to exclusively be for incels. I'm not sure exactly how it'd be done, but a program that involves socializing incels around people and women in a supervised manner. And then he has some more posts on Incel Exit. What does the future look like with male sexlessness increasing every year? Are normies just lying when they say sex and relationships are not a big deal? Now, this is one I want to get to because he, you know, allegedly killed his mother. So he writes, 71 days ago, feel my mother has played a role in me being a male virgin. And he says, like, for example, all her female friends are all much uglier than her because she is too insecure. That's just one example of many, many negative traits. Truly a vile creature, and I mean this objectively. Don't get me wrong, I don't hate women because of her. I just feel she played a subconscious role in my inability to ask a girl out for her number. And he says, it's like hitting a brick wall. Plenty of times girls have shown a lot of interest when younger at college, but I never asked them out. I'm almost 23. Don't even know how to meet even one woman. Haven't asked one since I was 17. And then, of course, is it surprising that someone like this also posts on the subreddit Men's Rights? So he writes with 44 upvotes, why do women struggle so badly to sympathize and understand men's plights, issues, and problems in society and life, but as men, we can easily sympathize and understand women's issues and problems? Said with, like, out irony, some guy blames his mother for his, like, you know, inadequacy, his problems with women, and then he writes, the title is self-explanatory. It seems women either just don't care or just don't understand or are so blinded by their belief that society is sexist and a patriarchy that they refuse to even believe men have gender-specific pronouns. Seems so many women just outright don't have a clue, but men rarely struggle with the problem when it comes to issues women have. Why is it like this? The irony isn't lost that this is on a subreddit called Men's Rights, talking about how they acknowledge the problems women have, but women can't acknowledge the problems men have, and he comments in his own post. P.S. for the feminists reading this, yes, some men might ignore women's issues, but pretty much most men can understand women's issues and the problems they deal with a lot of the time. Women outright have an issue even understanding what men's problems even are, let alone sympathizing them, which I think isn't true, but then obviously very telling from a guy who just killed a bunch of women. Now, it seems like the internet played some part in his radicalization, because he posts on the Virgin subreddit, reading up on Black Pill, Red Pill, and feminists complaining about men makes me feel it's impossible to even get a GF. Saying the Black Pill basically tells you you're human filth and deserve to be exterminated. There's no hope, you should just give up unless you're 6'2", 10 out of 10. Makes you super self-critical. I used to not focus much on my looks before reading up on the Black Pill. Basically gave me terrible image issues. The Red Pill tells you women are never loyal and you're wasting your time trying to even get a relationship and you should just stack cash and fuck as many whores as you can because they're all sluts and bitches. Anyway, there are no good women. And then there are feminists like Male Dating Strategy who just trash men all the time, say men are all trash and unless you meet all their requirements you don't even deserve anything. I know I shouldn't pay attention to it and that doesn't 100% reflect real life, but when you're socially isolated, no car and the computer is your only form of entertainment, you just find yourself reading up about this. I wish I never came across all this BS, it's just toxic negative BS. It also makes you feel like any self-improvement you do is never going to be enough. Does anyone feel this way? So it's clear that spending way too much online radicalized this guy, and it's nothing new. Posting on incel forums, he's posting on Men's Rights, you know, blaming women, saying that women do not understand men's issues, blaming a lot of people about why he can't get women or why he can't talk to girls. Also just really self-loathing. This guy clearly hates himself. So that plays into like the more traditional aspects of like often mass shooters who like hate the world. And often the shooting is one last F you before they go out. But then you have the added element of him basically hating women to an extent, saying like there are no good women, which he says in this post. but also really, really craving female attention. And on this post, he comments, "Reading up on all this crap hasn't added anything to my life. I can't wait until I can finally start my driving lessons and get a car and lockdown ends, start socialising more. And I forget about all this shite. All reading up about this stuff has just made me more frustrated, miserable and negative. I want to be in a position in life where I can cut out all social media and BS crap and just focus on my hobbies and things I enjoy in life." So here's a guy who clearly doesn't really want to be this way or act this way, but he clearly states here he has, you know, in a large way been radicalized by red pill, by black pill. And these things often mean like various different things. Like I've even said I've been like black pill before. He's more talking about this nihilistic thing blended with red pill men's rights crap. Combined together has made him into this crazed mass shooter who carried out one of the worst mass shootings in British history. Now, I want to end the Reddit section with one last comment he posted on his men's rights post. And if you want to read anything else about this, maybe go check this Reddit. I don't know if they're going to remove it, but he says, "Women's main privilege is that they never fail. Yes, women might not run the world, they might not run society, and men always are the biggest winners in society. Those with the most money, authority, success are men, but a women's privilege is that they can never fail. Look, my £600 life all have BF's husbands. Look at all the single mothers on welfare with free housing. When a woman has a problem, many men and women are there to support and help them. Unlike men, yes, men can have the greatest success in life, but we also have the greatest fails and the bottom of society, and those most worthless are always going to be men, criminals, prisons, the massive male homeless numbers, the social outcasts of society, the most forgotten people. The fact men get harsher sentences for the same crimes committed, people are less empathetic to men who fail or don't achieve in life. Nobody cares. Men are expendable, worthless until they provide or do something. Women are always going to support social, moral, monetary when they fail. Get knocked up, single mother government will help you out. Image issues, women and men will call you beautiful and give you a shoulder to cry on. Have no social circle, no problem. Women are naturally more socially developed than men, and they're also not viewed as a threat, so it's very easy to make friends or meet people. You also don't deal with the social shame of not performing. A woman isn't expected to perform or achieve anything. A woman will always have worth because of her reproductive qualities. When's the last time anyone called a woman a loser for working a minimum wage job at a coffee shop or living with her mother? Almost never. Men don't, we have to fight every battle on our own, and we must do so stoically without complaint and without moaning. If we're failing, we're just not trying hard enough. Man up, stop complaining like a bitch. We're a loser point. Being a man, you have to build your worth in society through blood, sweat and tears, especially if you're an outcast. Men also seen as far more dangerous and a threat, unreliable, trustworthy, which makes it harder for the bottom barrel men to get out of the rut they're in." So I could make like a whole video on men's rights just being this place where misogynistic rhetoric like this goes unchallenged, because that's what it is. Men's rights as a movement has always been, you know, a load of BS in my opinion. I know there's more progressive men's rights organization, as weird as that sounds, but at the end of the day, I feel like the people it attracts are always people like this. And even though this guy kind of acknowledged that men still dominate society, he kind of flips that, saying that, well, men have all these social expectations where women have none, so therefore women are always winning no matter what they're doing. So yeah, this guy was clearly like radicalized online. It probably doesn't surprise you that he was also a Trump supporting right winger. So the Raw story reported his political views. So UK mass shooter was a Trump supporter, incel. Prior to the shooting, Davison expressed his support for Donald Trump on his Facebook page and posted multiple self-pitying YouTube videos about how he looked, often using language common to the incel community. Davison, who claimed to be from Arizona, reportedly was obsessed with American conservative politics, following Trump and all of his children on Facebook, as well as other right-wing accounts, including those belonging to Senator Ted Cruz and Ted Nugent. "Trump has proven time and again he is indeed for the people," Davison wrote on Facebook. "You may not agree with his political views, but he is different from the scum like Hillary or the people running our country, like the neocon sellout that is Theresa May. Skepticism of the government is key, and everyone should be ready and prepared for anything bad that could happen. I am aware much of the government is deeply flawed, but there are many paedophiles that even reported devil-worshipping people that sell us out to foreign countries." Someone also posted some of his Facebook profile pictures, so apparently he was into the UK Libertarian Party, and he had a PragerU little thing of Donald Trump that says, "In America, we do not seek to impose our way of life on anyone, but rather to let it shine as an example for everyone to watch. So hopefully through those posts and some of those articles, I've given you a good insight to why this guy was motivated to carry out this act of violence. Although it's an emerging story, it's pretty clear when you look into the psychology of this guy through his Reddit posts and social media posts that he was motivated by a feeling of inadequacy, hatred towards his mother, blaming his mother for his problems in getting with women. And obviously he held like deeply misogynistic views, posted in all these forums, and actually, you know, says in one of his posts that the black pill, red pill stuff has kind of radicalized him, and he doesn't really want to think about these things, but it's starting to have an effect on him. So in the coming days, we'll see what happens. And there's a debate at the moment in the UK, because this is probably going up later, American time. Debate at the moment in the UK, is this a terrorist act? Is this motivated by a political ideology against women? Now, people are trying to like throw in a definition around, but these incel things, it is a growing problem, isn't it? Like, it's a growing threat to women and just general people. This guy killed pretty indiscriminately in the end after killing his mother. I believe you could call this terrorism because it has the political element. And like I said, from those posts, you can see he does have issues. And there are many mass shooters who often post a lot of stuff like this. But the incel red pill flavor to it, I think, does make it like this political act more so. Because it is clearly in part motivated by this stuff, his issues, especially with his mother. Whether or not there was an argument between them that escalated and then he obviously took her life before just going out in this killing spree, we don't know for sure at the moment. But even if we like remove this shooting, this stuff is something that's getting more and more common. And it's very telling that nearly all these people are in this right-wing ecosystem. Like he said, this guy's a Trump supporter, follows Trump's children on Facebook, talks about how Trump was good, talks about this conspiracy theory, which is very similar to one you hear in America right now. And so it is kind of like this American culture being imported around the world, this incel thing, these right-wing beliefs in Donald Trump and taking this militant action. So it's something that needs to be taken more seriously. This extreme misogyny that has been politicized in the incel community, and where incels differ from, I guess, your traditional misogynist, is that they don't only view women as lesser, they also just blame women for all their own problems, because a lot of, you know, misogynists in general have wives, have daughters and stuff, but people like this don't have success with women, that women owe them something, and women not, you know, liking them is because of how we view women in society, women's place in society, where they can get away with being judgmental and only going for the chads and stuff, and not going for your nice guy, your average Joe, who actually is like a really, really nice guy, and he'll treat you right, but maybe he's not the best looking. And that is the rhetoric you see a lot of these people. So I think it's something that is drastically not looked at enough by people who are meant to stop this kind of thing. And it shows another facet of online radicalization, because we talk a lot about the alt-right radicalization of young white men. But here we have a red pill radicalization of a young white man. And unlike being like a neo-Nazi, this guy just has extreme misogynist views, specifically. Unlike neo-Nazis who often have misogyny in terms of their general radicalized beliefs. But it's a disturbing trend that continues to get worse and worse, it seems. But anyway, let me know what you guys think down in the comments. If you want to follow me on social media, at The Cavernacle on Twitter and Instagram, come join our communities on Discord and on Reddit. And if you made it this far, thank you all for watching.